death to quickies.
In the panicked wake of 9/11, there were cases of anthrax being sent through the mail, resulting in 5 deaths. Anthrax is a natural bacteria, Bacillus anthracis, but there are weaponized strains made for biological weapons, and this was one of them. What wasn't known was who made the strain and who was sending it out. But very quickly, information leaked to ABC News claiming it came from Saddam Hussein, who of course ended up having no weapons of mass destruction and no connection to the 9/11 attacks. But ABC News claimed that the anthrax powder contained the dangerous and nefarious substance bentonite, only found in Iraq. In reality, bentonite is a harmless clay found all over the world. It's used in ceramics, cat litter, adhesive, cosmetics, and even soap. But this was used to point the finger at Hussein, and ABC's Peter Jennings even claimed that bentonite made the anthrax much more dangerous. And he had on an expert to say that it was a trademark of Hussein's biological weapons program. A program that, as was later confirmed, never existed. And it turns out there wasn't even any bentonite in the anthrax to begin with. It actually took years for them to discover the alleged culprit, who they claimed was an American infectious disease scientist named Bruce Ivins, who worked in a U.S. Army lab in Fort Detrick. He developed the strain of anthrax known as the AIM strain as part of a government program under the supervision of Dr. Anthony Fauci. Ivins died in an apparent suicide before he could be arrested. In a later review of the case, the FBI said that the case against Ivins had been overstated. If Ivins really was involved, he probably wasn't acting alone. So who was really behind it, and why, remains a mystery. The bigger question is, why was the U.S. government developing biological weapons to begin with, especially after signing the Biological Weapons Convention in 1972? And also, can you really trust them when they say now they're not running any bioweapons labs at home or abroad?